Hi, this is Chelsea from Ref and Write. In this video, we will look at some strategies for presenting negative and unexpected results in your paper. If you still haven't subscribed to this channel, please click the subscribe button below. Do not suppress negative results in your paper. Don't worry if your experiments did not yield the results that you were expecting. Don't try to ignore or downplay the result just because it doesn't support your hypothesis. It doesn't mean that your research is a failure. Negative results are as good as positive results. Actually, you should have discovered a useful piece of evidence that your experiments don't work. This is an important contribution to the scientific community so that future researchers can learn from your work and modify their experiments to avoid the mistake you did in your work. Here is an example from a social sciences research paper. The author's original hypothesis is that there is a link between the use of technology in classrooms and student grades. But after conducting the experiments, their data showed that there is no link. This clearly contradicts their hypothesis. It turns out that this finding is also in contrast to previous papers published on this topic in the literature. Now the authors are finding themselves in a difficult position, having to explain their findings to the readers. The authors are saying that this might be because intelligent kids might be using technology outside the classroom. So it doesn't matter whether they are using technology in classrooms or not, they will still do better. This sounds plausible and it sounds convincing enough. This is what research is all about. It is not just about finding something new. It is also about questioning things that we already know. Let's look at another example here. This is from a health sciences research paper. The authors are saying that they did not find any evidence of vitamin C in any of the samples in the experiment. This contradicts their hypothesis and some of the previous findings in the literature. Now the authors are explaining why they think they got the result. They think this might be due to various factors such as improper treatment, poor storage, oxidative stress, etc. As you can see, the authors are honest about their findings and are trying to provide a rational explanation to justify their results. If you have any questions, please drop a message below. We will answer it as soon as possible. If you still haven't installed Ref and Write software, please do it. It comes with referencing tools, plagiarism checkers, proofreading tools, paraphrasing tools, an academic phrase bank, and many other useful features to help you write your research papers and thesis. You can sign up for free using the link below in the description. If you are interested in training courses on research and academic writing, please visit our Learning Academy on Udemy. You can find the link in the description below. Finally, please subscribe to our channel to get future updates. Bye for now!